Students of the La Guerre Combined School sat outside their classrooms Tuesday amid reports that the school building was infested with termites. However, the school says the reports were not quite accurate.
Saying infested with termites is not the reality here. We do have a little bit of termites in some of the classrooms, and over the past weekend it was treated. Now I think the chemical that was used was a bit strong. When we returned to school on Monday morning, the furniture, the walls, the smell was a bit strong, and some of our teachers we have one or two teachers who are asthmatic. We have quite a few students who are asthmatic as well, and many other children have a reaction, the itching. So we didn't think that it was a good environment for them.
As a result, the principal and the education officer for the district took a decision to send the children home. But the problem persisted.
We are back here again. It's Tuesday and the smell is still there. It's the same. It's even outside this, because we have not been into the room and we are outside and children are still reacting. So we still believe that it is not a good environment for them. So the principal is still awaiting word from our district education officer as to what we're going to do today. But right now we are still outside waiting.
The La Guerre Combined School was built in 1970 and subsequently relocated to its current site using the same materials. As a result of the age of the building, school authorities say the wood is not as strong as it used to be. As a result, termites may continue to pose a problem.
I'm saying so because we were close, we are very close to getting the new school, and it is not so anymore. I don't think we are going to get a new school. But with this thing happening now, with the material that is built, I believe there is a need to reconsider the new school, probably in wall and not wood. That would be good for Lagos School.
The school has had termites before, but says a situation has never developed until now where students had to be sent home. For the DBS News World, Melissa Paul reporting.